Well, actually, her hair has grown out quite a bit. It was tapered and tighter on the sides as well as the nape of the neck. Linda has multi-tones. She's a highlighted client with a dark brown, well, medium brown base. Also, she has her mingling gray that's actually coming in. So we highlight her to the golden tones because it actually marries in with her hair that has been decolorized due to life, and it just blends. Also, it complements her light brown eyes, as you can see.
Mm-hmm.
So with Miss Linda, basically she has a style that is easy for her home maintenance. We don't want to release her too much weight, then she loses control of being able to roll it if need be or do some type of curl placement if need be. So actually all I'm gonna do is go in, lightly tip her ends and basically keep her form as is. She's at a point in her life, she wants a hairstyle that's low maintenance. Because she's a busy woman on the go.
This is the Linda haircut. In this session, we're giving Linda a haircut, a trim actually. We're taking off about an eighth of an inch to half an inch. We're blending the top crown and the upper back. We're nipping the ends with the scissors. And now we're going down and we're blending the lower back with the upper back. Throughout the cutting process, you always want to check your progress. In this session, we're creating rounded layers throughout her hair. We want a weightless layered hairstyle with a rounded shape. Right here, we're over directing the hair from the back section to the side section. We're cutting off the pointed tips. That's what's going to keep our shape rounded. You want to pull the hair taut. You want to make sure you have all the hair in the same direction when you cut. After we've trimmed the sides and the back, we move to the crown section. Using her head as the guide, we want to make sure the hair is no longer than 4 to 5 inches in the crown. We begin by holding the hair straight up at a 90 degree angle, and we gradually graduate down to a 45 degree angle as we blend the crown with the sides. And we continue nipping the pointed ends off to ensure our rounded, layered hairstyle shape. We finish with the scissors carving a defined edge. We always like to work in sections. We begin in the lower back and lower crown, and we worked our way to the left side, blending the top and bottom, the back and right sides together. Once that was completed, now we're going in and we're trimming her edge. We're using the scissors for a defined style line. This haircut is already looking good. Once your hair is cut in a distinct style, you don't have to worry about if it's straight or curly, kinky or what. It's always going to maintain its shape. Okay, now we're going in and we're trimming the crown and we're blending the crown with the front right panel. Just like the process on the left side, on the right side, we're using the head as our guide, and we're holding the hair in the crown up at a 90 degree angle. We're cutting off no more than a half an inch of hair. This is just a trim. You see how we're elevating the hair right at the front hairline up at a 90 degree angle. What that is going to achieve is a longer fringe with a graduated shorter crown. Yep, that's how you get that crown. You should probably stop and rewind this to see the elevation of the front fringe to the crown. By holding the hair straight up at a 90 degree elevation, that is going to create a layered effect. And by over-directing the fringe to meet with the crown, that will make the fringe longer. And that's how you achieve that graduated effect from the shortest point in the top crown to the longest point in the front fringe. You see the finger position as we're trimming and blending the crown with the sides? This is a truly versatile haircut. The fringe can be combed to the right side, the left side, or straight back for a pompadour effect. What really makes this haircut fresh are those sideburns. But don't sleep on that disconnected fringe, because that's what makes this Linda haircut everything. You can adjust the length of the fringe to give you a varied hairstyle effect. You can leave it super long down to the nose. You can have it longer down to the chin, and you can keep everything else really tight and close. That's the versatility of the layered, rounded hairstyle, the Linda haircut. We continuously cross-check the haircut throughout the process. Now that the hair is dried, we're going to take off a fraction just in the crown, and that will give us the added height that we're looking for. And see here where we're blending the upper back, holding it straight up at a 90 degree angle and causing it to meet with a shorter crown. That gives you that gradual blending of layers. Now we're about to apply some nourishing lip serum to her clean, dried hair. You can already see the serum begin to transform her hair. Now, this nourishing lipid serum is 100% organic. It's cold-pressed oils combined with various essential oils. It is an amazing combination. It penetrates the cuticle layers to nourish and enhance elasticity. Just look at her hair. You can already see the difference. We haven't even used a flat iron or a curling iron. We've simply smoothed the serum on, and we're finger combing the hairstyle. The right haircut and the right hair color can change your life. And this haircut and hair color is everything. The haircut is versatile. She can style her hair several ways. The color is amazing. It complements her skin tone and her eye color. Our hair grows approximately a half an inch per month. So when your client has a super short haircut or a very tight perimeter, you need to have her in there every 4 weeks to keep the design line crisp. It was the over-directed fringe, the bang that we dragged back to the start point in the crown, that gave us this length and disconnection in the fringe. But it's really the sideburns, right, that distinguish this haircut. And look at it, polished and smooth with a flat iron. The color is on point, the cut is on point, and it's going to be easy for her to maintain at home.